storage facility, the addition of staff parking, construction of a 30-foot by 50-foot office building, construction of concrete slabs to accommodate a new sorting line for building material recycling, addition of a fueling station with an above-ground storage tank, a vehicle wash area, and construction of a vehicle maintenance building. An area is also designated for future construction of a building to house a composting facility. I would like to share a few testimonies, a few personal testimonies from some of the military companies. One military couple attended the meeting on April 13, 2017, Mr. and Mary Simon.
Dr. Munson, and I believe we dealing with this situation it's on our agenda as well, so you should hear something come out of this. Thanks so very much. Madam Clerk, do you want to sign up for it? Again, thank you, Dr. Munson, for that informative information about that. I see here, David Ross. Council. Taking this team sport and developing the skills.
make sure that we're setting them up in order to have that opportunity. The dual enrollment is vital for our kids. We're looking at reducing the number of student loans children have to take out in order to complete their post-secondary education. And so our goal is that all of our children, when they get in the 11th grade, that 13 dual enrollment, whether that's the Coastal Pines or the College of Coastal Georgia. Each class that they take, that saves them $15 million. We have a young man that will graduate this year that will complete 3 hours. So he will go on when he leaves Brunswick, and he's going to Pennsylvania to go to school. He will be enrolling as a sophomore, but that's come from the support that we've been able to provide. So if those soccer things that they learn here, the adversity that they have to work through, we can't call timeouts. So when there's a problem, these kids have to solve it themselves. And that teamwork plays into every aspect of their lives as they become adults. So we're just seeing an opportunity to continue our partnership, to continue the growth rate that we're currently experiencing. One of the other and last thing we want to cover is we met with a gentleman that works with General Motors, their national headquarters. We talked about STEM programs. And so they are now putting together a proposal that we will bring STEM to our, but the thing they're asking for, send me a picture of your facility. They are looking at providing us with all the equipment that's needed to have a STEM program to be able to offer that to our kids. If you look at numbers now, particularly our young ladies, nationally, the 7.8% of young ladies are in the STEM programs. We have an opportunity to directly get back that. Get a partnership with the GM Corporation in order to bring something to our kids that we currently do not have access to in our community. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
raise my hand.
Is it not stipulated somewhere that they are not permitted to have municipal solid waste on site or
that
comes in and goes out the same day?
That's true. That is all stored. Municipal solid waste that comes along that site is all stored within that existing building that they clean out, they wash down. The 60-foot pile that we referenced earlier
haven't been able to satisfy our community. So therefore, maybe they need to take it even higher to state, let them be aware of what's happening in that community down there. So that's what I was suggesting to y'all. Although I know it's not a solution, but could be help a process to help you alleviate some of that dust area that's going on.
Is there a chance number? Is there a contact?
We have a contact, but I'm probably work with Jason.
That would be a good point. So you look at, so they make this federal government, so you know they said they take it seriously. They do get a sign, case number,
well,
they
mark
it.
It's state.
Thank you, John. Thank you for being
CEO of the Coastal Georgia Community Action Authority Incorporated, Julie Martin, Commissioner of City of Brunswick, William Mounts, Dean and Professor of Economic School of Business and Public Management of the College of Coastal Georgia, Travis Siegel, Director for the Department of Economic and Community Development, Denali Trimble, Representative or Employee of the Georgia Environmental Protection Division. So we try our best to recruit individuals who research and who have understanding or who desire an understanding for the CDBG block grant funds. To give you a breakdown of where the monies have been approved by the Advisory Council for 2017-18, $67,284 will be allocated for program admin, and that's for general administration costs such as funding, staffing, equipment, training, in addition to any consultation services that are needed. Affordable housing is our minor major emergency home repair program, which $100,000 has been allocated from that particular program. Our anticipated service number of homes are 20 low-income homes within the city of Brunswick. Public facilities and infrastructure, and that is for us to be able to provide upgrade services to our public facilities, such as the Roosevelt Lawrence Gym, which has been out at $50,000 for that particular area. Economic development in the form of the micro business enterprise is $68,674,000, which will provide technical assistance, but not limited to micro business loans, assistance with small startup and training for businesses to be located in the city of Brunswick. The goal is to assist 20 businesses by the end of 2018.
is one of 5,000 examples of the same type building in the city, and the loss of it will have no bearing on anything going forward. It's not associated with anybody who has any major historical ties to the city. So we're doing our job to help facilitate that.
So that's I mean, honestly, yes, you as the commission can shorten the time frame. When you get back to the drawing board, we have to take it back.
So what y'all want to do? 9 days?
No, probably 20 days.
We'll get one to the board.
Yeah, I don't think this is way too long. Keep waiting.
city, they want to negotiate this out. Higher than we're paying, and we are going to negotiate. As long as you don't make it more expensive than it's doing in the house, you're probably going to be able to deal with it. And it shows that. The whole time this is happening, we're still out there working on the project in-house. And so I refer to the second page with my son. It's kind of the, so I just look back. We still have on the table tonight, and we wish to go to the county's agreement, because it's also 160. These can't be done overnight. Overnight can't be done, but the current structure would take a little bit more time to decide the functional city manager. Of course, they're going to take an election next fall, just give you the options. We could operate with one system and you could change how you do the approach because of
sure.
But this is how we would take it, this is how we would fund it. I believe we can do it. I do know that the clerk tax commission. And if you have a copy of the memo that she sent out to you earlier this week, because it has been
And for us to say, okay, well, here we go. We just sit here. This stuff is, this got to stop.
We're ready to go. First meeting.
We're not ready to go.
First meeting in February, I sat down with two software companies. And we went through the product, and I was there, and I said, tonight, I have two companies that potentially can work with us. We may have more if we put it out to bid. We put the proposals together, we're purchasing, we put it out, our bids have come back, the proposals have come back. They're both viable, but I do think the higher product is better.
true.